gas. We've got local governments and state governments and even some federal politicians want everybody to get off gas. But reports now saying more and more homeowners want gas, obviously because it's great for heating your home. But also with power supply worries, electricity worries, people are thinking, well, if there's a blackout, at least I can still cook my dinner, Justin. Does it surprise you or not?
No, it doesn't surprise me that they're talking about it, but I've got to admit, I'm with you lot about this. They'll be prying gas out of my cold, dead hand. I've got to say, I bloody love it. I love gas in the kitchen, and the thought of it being replaced with something else just sends shivers down my spine. But I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm going to have to give it up at some point.
You don't have to give it up.
Fight for your rights, Justin.
You want me to hold on? I'll hold on if you want me to hold on.
I'll be right next to you in the trenches. What this says, though, the fact that these gas companies are saying we've got an unprecedented amount of demand, people saying we want gas in our homes. What this says to us is, despite all the lobby groups, despite all the fear-mongering, despite government being like climate, communism or bust, the everyday person is like, stuff yours. I want gas in my home. Well, and lastly, this also goes to show why government has now resorted to just mandating no gas. Like we've seen in Victoria, if you are building a new home, if you're building a new block of apartments, no gas.
It's terrible.
It is.
This is where I came into this. My council's doing this.
Don't remind me.
Government who can't bring the people with them.
No, they can't.
So then they just go, well, we're forcing you.
Yeah, well, people know what works, and gas fires work. And we spent untold money on, you know, big renovations at our place. The best thing was the gas fire. I'll be there tomorrow night watching the footy, glass of red gas fire.
Nice.
Can't wait. And, this is outrageous that they try and legislate it away from us. Hey, just quickly, another bit of madness in Victoria, Justin, where the Cancer Council's wanting to ban junk food ads on your public transport. I mean, people can make up their own minds, can't they, about what they're going to eat.
Oh, mate, look, I hate the idea of banning stuff too, but I've got to say obesity and poor nutrition is at the base of some really awful problems in Australia. Can we not look to America and see where they've been going wrong? And I'm not trying to sling off the Americans here, but in the last few decades, they have really gone down a bad track. Do we want to go down? And we are heading down that direction.
I hate the idea of banning something,
but I'd love to see fewer junk food ads.
I would like to lose 3 kilograms. Do you think the government can do that for me, or do you think at some stage we actually run our own lives? Unbelievable. Let me go quickly to the US. We're talking about targeting kids.
You're not a kid, Chris. You're not a kid, mate. We're talking about targeting kids.
I have kids, mate, and I know what you do when you raise kids. You raise them to make the right decisions, and at a certain point of their life, they do make their own decisions.
Again, you were asking the government to be the parent.
Yeah, raise my kids.
Well, let's have cigarette ads then.
So we'll get the government to tell our kids what to eat, what gender they should be.
Exactly.
Unbelievable. Let's go to the US where things are a lot more sensible.
Oh, crap.
Despite all the demonisation and hatred in US politics, Joe Biden doesn't sound like he's going to pull back on his attacks against Donald Trump. Have a listen.
Just because we must lower the temperature and our politics is ready to violence, it doesn't mean we should stop telling the truth. Who you are, what you've done, what you'll do, that's fair game.
Look, I reckon this is reckless, Liz, because what he's saying is really the victim of most of the hatred in Donald Trump should be the one to lower his temperature. The rest of us will keep attacking him.
100%. And what he's doing here is sticking with the Dems' narrative of, no, we have the upper ground.
Yeah, the high moral ground.
The morality of this. Yes, we're up on the high horse. We have the high moral ground. And it feeds into that very dangerous narrative of, well, whatever happens, is it really undeserved? Mm. And that is something that simply cannot continue along this trajectory. We've got months until the election. Heaven knows. I doubt very much this is going to be the first and only attempt to take Donald Trump's life.
Oh, well, I hate to speculate about stuff.
President,
like that,
but, it's barely been, 3 days since that horrific incident, and Trump's life was spared by less than a millimetre, and yet he's not ramping it down at all.
It's incredible.